Well, now I'm going to share with you my top five takeaways from this book, that is Attitude is Everything by Jeff Keller. Basically, there are a lot of takeaways from this book, definitely. And you can see, like, I have marked so many things from this book. Like, look at that. Yes, right. I've marked so many important things. But in this video, I'm going to share with you my top five takeaways from this particular book. So the first takeaway is, you can see over here, he talks about success begins in the mind. And I'm going to talk about the first quote that has been written is, success is a state of mind. If you want success, start thinking of yourself as a success. If you want to become successful in life, first you have to see yourself as a successful being. Now, how is that possible? You have to train your mind by constantly feeding positive thoughts that I am successful. Even if you are not, you keep feeding those positive thoughts in your mind saying that I am confident, I am successful, I am successful. Okay, and you have to start believing in those thoughts that you are successful. You can also use the affirmations, which are basically like, I am successful, or I am a winner, I am a champion. You know, you keep using these mantras, you keep using this prayer, and you start believing in them, okay? So for initially, it's going to be a very different process. It's going to be extremely difficult for a newbie, okay? So what do you really do over here is that you start training your mind. Okay, there's a famous quote that says, fake it till you make it, okay? So you have to fake that you're successful until it becomes your new norm. And what I mean by this is, you have to fake that you're successful, whether it's in your mind, whether it's in your physiological or in your psychological perspective. You have to fake it until you make it. They say, win in your mind and you will win in your reality. Okay, so the first quote over here is that success is a state of mind. If you want success, start thinking of yourself as a success. So my second takeaway from this book is, you can see over here, picture your way to success. So basically, this topic is all about visualization. He says that you have to picture yourself as a winner. You have to picture yourself as a successful human being, and you have to keep playing that mental movie in your mind over a period of time. And I'm very sure that if you're an athlete watching this, you might have seen n number of videos on YouTube. They talk about visualization and how visualization can play a very important role in your life, important role in your performance. So coming back to the quote that really impressed me was that you must first clearly see a thing in your mind before you can do it, right? So the best example over here for visualization is Michael Phelps, okay? If you go and check any of his videos on YouTube, or if you have read his biography, you will notice that he is practice the race in his mind. He has literally visualized the race in his mind for like hundreds of times, like dozens and hundreds of times before he has gone out there and put the show, okay? And without visualization, it is not possible for any player to become greatest of all time, okay? So use the method of visualization. This is my second takeaway from this book, is you must first clearly see a thing in your mind before you can do it. You can see over there. Okay, so go get your copy. You will get to read the entire chapter on this, which is Picture Your Way to Success. And he's explained beautifully. Okay, so go ahead and get your copy today. My third takeaway from this book is the way he has explained about turn your problems into opportunities, right? Now, as athletes, we face so many adversities on a day-to-day basis, right? We have so many problems, literally. We have like personal problems, then education problem, then we have a professional problem, injury problems, so many problems. And as an athlete, I understand it is very difficult to cope up with all of these things. We have a lot of pressure. We have a lot of criticism from people and so many adversities that we go through, you know. And Jeff has explained amazingly how you can actually turn your problems into opportunities. So the one takeaway from this particular chapter that I love the most is, he says, there's a quote from Mary Case, there is no pressure, no diamonds. I love this quote, you know, like, no pressure, no diamonds. And why this is the quote is because you see the diamonds, which is the most precious thing and the most beautiful thing, it is being made under high pressure. You know, those beautiful diamonds, they are made under high pressure. And this is for all of you watching out there. If you want to become successful, if you want to win, you have to work under high pressure. You have to figure out a way to work under high pressure. I like the way people say in sports, right? Like, pressure is a privilege. And for all of you athletes watching this, pressure is a privilege. If you have no pressure, you are considered as no athlete, because, you know, any normal person can work under no pressure. But if you are working under high pressure, and especially this is during competitions, right? You have high pressure, you have pressure from every single, you know, you have pressure from audience, from media, you have your own pressure built up, then you have coaches, you have your parents watching this game. So you have been pressure built up, not just during the competition, but it starts somewhere 2-3 days or maybe even 1 week before the competition. So always I want you to remember, next time if you're facing some problem related to pressure, remember, no pressure, no diamonds. So if you want to become successful, if you want to win, and if you think that there is a lot of pressure, there's a huge mountain on my head and I don't know how to handle it, right? So I want you to remember, if you want to become successful, if you want to win that match, if you want to win that round, if you want to win that championship, you have to deal with the pressure, because only once you deal with the pressure will you be able to become successful. So my third takeaway from this book is, no pressure, no diamonds. That is, turn your problems into opportunities. My fourth takeaway from this book is, as you can see over here, associate with positive people. The way you surround yourself with people matters. The way you are around people also matters. Like, who are you spending the most time with? Okay, your environment matters a lot. There's a famous quote that says, you are the average of 5 people you spend time with, right? So who are your 5 people? And are you really able to use this quote, that is, you are the average of 5 people you spend time with? And are these 5 people uplifting you, motivating you, helping you achieve your goals? And are they on a similar mission as you? And even if they are not, are they uplifting you? Do they accept you, the person that you are? Okay, so the most important quote, or it's from Proverbs 27, probably from Bible. They say, a mirror reflects a man's face, but what he is really like is shown by the kind of friends he chooses. Okay, so let's be honest, the way I am talking, the way you behave, the way you talk, the way you respond, or the way you behave on a day-to-day basis is a reflection of the people you are surrounded with, okay? Surround yourself with people who are on similar mission as you. You know, if you are focusing on physical fitness, then surround yourself with the people who are focusing on fitness, who are focusing on diet, who have a goal or a target in life, and you will be able to achieve success. The way you surround with people and who are the people that you surround with matters a lot, because these are the people who are going to help you achieve success. These are the people who are going to help you climb the performance ladder upward. So the choice is yours. So the fourth takeaway from this book is, associate with positive people. My fifth takeaway from this book is about fear. We all deal with fear, we all deal with uncertainties, but there comes a particular situation in our life where we have to make a decision, right? Like, should I confront the fear, or should I just leave it as it is, or just wait for someone else to do it? And there is this beautiful lesson from this book that Jeff Keller has explained about, confront your fears and grow. He says that how fear helps you grow. And I'm going to tell about the most famous quote that has been said by Raffaello Emerson. He says, do the thing you fear the most, and the death of fear is certain. Now, I'm going to repeat this to you because this is my personal favorite quote by Raffaello Emerson. He says, do the thing you fear the most, and the death of fear is certain. So for all of you watching this today, maybe you've been holding yourself back to go do workouts, or maybe you're holding yourself back and saying that maybe I'll start the diet from, you know, next week, or maybe you're just holding yourself back from doing the things that you really want to do. Why? Because you are scared, because you're filled with fear, because you don't want to get out of your comfort zone. So the best thing you can do is confront your fear, and you will get to know what the final output is going to be. So the best way is just get out of that fear nutshell and explore what is there beyond your comfort zone, because that is going to help you grow. So the fifth takeaway from this book is that, confront your fears and grow. So guys, these were my 5 takeaways from this book. Now I want to hear from you. Okay, go ahead and purchase the copy of this book, Attitude is Everything by Jeff Taylor. I can guarantee you, you are going to love this book. If you do not like reading, then you can go and listen to this book on Audible as well, okay? Which particular chapter or which particular quote or which particular circumstance or incident that you loved from this book, and what are your positive perspectives or what are your takeaways from this book? Comment below, and I'm really excited to see you change as a human being. Let's change this last quarter of the year on a positive perspective. Let's end this last quarter of the year on a positive note by dealing with ourselves, by giving ourselves chance to grow, okay? And what best place than self-help? So that's all I got for you for today. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. Take care until then, and more powers to you. Remember, attitude is everything.